The second step is these monomers are fermented into organic acids. So now the step is what? The step is called as acidogenesis. So these soluble compounds, which are prepared because of the action of facultative anaerobic decomposing bacteria, as they convert these complex biomolecules into simple biomolecules or monomer. Now these monomers are acted upon by another set of bacteria or microorganism which cause fermentation. So they ferment and finally convert these monomers into organic acids, basically acetic acid. The favorite one or maximum time produced acid in this concept is the acetic acid. So finally this acetic acid is formed by and this step is called as acidogenesis. So once the acid is formed or organic acid is formed, now the next step is the organic acids are acted upon by the methanogenic bacteria to produce biogas or a mixture of methane and carbon dioxide, some amount of hydrogen also, H2 is also possible. So organic acids is acted upon by methanogenic bacteria, third step, and it is called as methanogenesis, and finally biogas is produced. So the three steps are solubilization, acidogenesis, methanogenesis. Solubilization converts the complex organic compounds into simple compounds or monomers. Then second step, monomers are converted into organic acids, generally the acetic acid, by fermenting microorganism. So first step is done by facultative anaerobic decomposers. Second step is done by fermenting microorganisms. And third step is the organic acids is changed into methane gas. So methanogenesis is the last step, during which methanogenic bacteria, I gave you the name from the NCERT as well as the other one also. So these microorganisms finally cause the formation of the methane gas. So what are the benefits of this whole process? It is easy to store this form of energy. Then it is more efficiently and it functions more efficiently and is economically better. Then the spent slurry can still be used as organic fertilizers in the farms or in the fields in the rural area. Then this improves the sanitization by minimizing the chances of fecal pathogens. So what I told you, house flies and all, they are not able to pass on infection to the human anymore because sanitization or hygienic condition. The conditions become more hygienic, more clean environment in the village if biogas production starts. Because the heaps of that big heap of cow dung would be gone from the village. Then this concept is an eco-friendly method of production of pollution-free source of energy, and then it is used as a fuel for heating, cooking, lighting, power, as well as alternate source of energy. So you can see this diagram. From one side, the dung and water mixture is added. Same diagram is in the NCERT, and then it is passed into the digester tank. This digester tank will have a floating drum on top of it, which is lighter in weight, and then there is a outlet for the gas also. There can be a speedometer type of thing, so what you call as a pressure reading type of thing, which is able to understand how much gas is produced inside because this lid is going to rise up. And this is the way you enter the dung and water mixture of 1:1 into it. And from this side, you are supposed to take out the slurry so that it can be used now for the spent slurry comes here, and then it is supposed to be used for fertilizers in the field. So this is the concept of the biogas plant. Please remember from the NCERT this line that this technology of the biogas production was developed in India mainly due to the efforts of Indian Agriculture Research Institute IARI and Khadi and Village Industries Commission KVIC. And another main thing that NCERT has given the name of just one microorganism, which is a methanogen, and that is Methanobacterium. So you need to be writing this example first. If you are reading other notes, other things, you are supposed to write the other microorganism names later. first you should refer to the NCERT examples. So in the next class, we are going to start, we will be trying to finish this chapter by finishing the biopesticides and biofertilizer topic.